Hi everybody, my name is Josh Livni. Welcome to Google Maps Developers Live. So this week I want to talk to you about a new layer in the Maps API that lets you render private or public content that's stored in Google Maps Engine in a pretty cool new way. So to get a little bit of context, first I want to show you here on my screen a demonstration of our Maps Engine layer, which has been out for a while and renders data sets that are stored in Google Maps Engine. So what I have here is some watersheds, some reasonably complex polygons, not too many of them, but it could potentially be millions of features here, same general technique. And the workflow that's going on behind the scenes is this data is being rendered on our servers as image tiles. There's a lot of products that sort of use the same approach, so nothing particularly new here. And what we can do generally with this approach is we get a little slightly different cursor as we mouse over. We can have click events, usually it opens an info window. Here I'm just zooming in to that particular feature. So nothing new here. That's our Maps Engine layer. It's cool, lets you display tons of complex data sets very fast. You'll notice as we zoom in and out, it renders very quickly. So now let's take a look at our new dynamic Maps Engine layer and some of the differences. So here we have the exact same data set, exact same sort of general code, except we're calling the dynamic Maps Engine layer instead of the Maps Engine layer in our code. And I've added some extra handling. And some of the handling that we can do is take advantage of new mouse events. So you'll notice as I hover over, I'm dynamically redrawing the polygons that I'm getting mouse over and mouse out events on. And when I click on a polygon here, what it's doing is it's loading up another Maps Engine layer, dynamic Maps Engine layer, excuse me, of the sub-watersheds for a given watershed. And similarly here, as I mouse over, I get different events getting fired from the dynamic Maps Engine layer, and I can pay attention to those and redraw. I can also, if you take a look at the info box on the left, get some information from the features and put some information in there. And the way that I'm doing that on the back end is I'm using the Maps Engine API to download some feature information and then do a lookup. As I mouse over here, I get the feature ID. I do a lookup into the Maps Engine API response and paint that information, such as the area of the sub-watershed, in this little info box here. So a lot of cool things you can do with this kind of almost instantaneous redraw. What's going on behind the scenes here is, similarly, we're rendering tiles, but this time it's vector tiles. And these vector tiles are kind of optimized for the zoom level that you're at, simplified and so forth. So you get a really snappy response as you zoom in, seeing all of the data in a nice kind of small vector format, and you get this extra interactivity. So there's a lot of things you can do here. So just a quick look at our documentation on some ways to get started. If you're interested in rendering public content, you can do that as well. People who have stored public data sets in Maps Engine, or of course, if you have your own private data, you can use OAuth and just make sure that the people that you want to have access to it can access your data using the dynamic Maps Engine layer. The documentation here is under libraries, under our JavaScript documentation. So go to Libraries, Visualization Library, and then Maps Engine Layer. And we have some simple examples to kind of get you started. You'll notice here the Maps Engine Layer. We have just a basic click on a polygon. We get kind of our info window. Scroll down the Dynamic Maps Engine Layer. We can redraw on the fly with different kinds of effects just on hover. So pretty cool. We look forward to seeing what kind of stuff you build with this. Let us know on feedback below this video or on Google+ or Twitter. We love to see the kinds of things you guys are doing. And hope you enjoy the new Dynamic Maps Engine layer. Until next time, I'm Josh Livni. Have a great week.